Hi guys, this is Lauren from Tider Robotics. Today we're going to show you how to build our new FlightStand 60 engine test stand. First off, make sure you have a flat surface to work on. Then install the four lower L brackets at the bottom of the stand beam using the M6 socket head screws. At the top of the stand beam, you can begin installing the four upper L brackets with more M6 screws. The stand structure itself can be built anywhere, but you'll need to attach it to your ground base before installing the engine. Next, install the two 45-degree support beams on adjacent sides of the square stand beam with the M8 socket head screws. Keep in mind that the support beams must face the opposite direction as your engine, so install them accordingly. Tighten all screws and bolts to the fastening torques indicated in the written user manual. For the purpose of this video, we are using a simple metal bar held down by some counterweights to prevent the stand from tipping. But for your test setup, you'll need to design something much sturdier to withstand the forces generated by your engine and propeller during your tests. You'll find an example in the written user manual. Reinforce the lower structure with the two M6 long bolts. You'll note that there are two more long bolts in your kit, but these are installed at a later step, so leave them aside for now. Next, install the force measurement unit on top of the stand using M6 socket head screws. The screw should pass through each of the four upper L brackets, and it should be installed facing the opposite side as the 45-degree support beams. Then attach the three metal spacers to the front of the FMU, passing six M5 screws from the back through the front of the FMU and the spacers. The next step is to mount your engine on the engine mounting plate. Since every engine is unique, we provide the plate but leave it to you to drill the holes in accordance with your motor's unique mounting points. We recommend measuring the spacing and tracing the location of the mounting points on the plate before drilling. We also recommend performing a test fit before installing the engine on the mounting plate, as some engines may require extra clearance for canisters or exhaust pipes. You can add spacers between the engine and mounting plate if necessary. Then, insert the three dampers into the engine mounting plate. You may need to lubricate them beforehand. You can use this guide, which is also printed in the user manual, to determine which dampers are right for your engine. Now we will mount the engine mounting plate on the FMU. Line up the dampers with the spacers and pass the M8 screws through the washers and each of the components, screwing them directly into the FMU and tightening them to the indicated fastening torque. Next, we will install the fuel flow sensor. Place the support plate on a flat surface as shown, and line up the fuel flow sensor with the holes on the plate. Make sure that the fuel inlet is on the left and the outlet is on the right. Pass the M3 screws up through the bottom of the plate and secure them with the lock nuts on the top side. Then install the fuel flow converter unit on the other end of the support plate with two M5 button head screws and M5 nuts on the bottom of the plate. Connect the fuel flow sensor to the converter with the green terminal JST cable. The converter unit is powered with a 5-volt DC power supply of your choosing. Connect the Jetty amplifier unit with one side to the JST white header and the other side's 2.54mm header to the brown, red, orange input on the converter unit. Insert the JST wire in the FMU port on the converter unit. Now we will move back to the stand, where we will attach the support plate on the upper L brackets behind the FMU using M6 socket head screws. The fuel flow sensor should be facing downwards. Optionally, you can design a custom support structure to allow you to mount your fuel tank above the fuel flow sensor plate, using the same screw slots to secure it. Next, we will prepare the fiber optic RPM sensor system. You can perform these steps in an order that is convenient for you. In this video, we will start by preparing the mounting fixtures, placing the support arm in the arm holder, and securing it with an M4 screw. The arm holder is then mounted on the upper L brackets of the stand using two long M6 screws, washers, and hex nuts. Install the sensor holder on the end of the support arm, then feed the fiber optic sensor through the holder and secure it with the M6 split lock washer and steel hex nut. You want to position the sensor so the light beam is orthogonal to the propeller and at least 30mm away. Keep in mind the propeller pitch when selecting the position. We will now install the fiber optic amplifier support on the 45-degree support beams of the stand using two M8 T-nuts. Be very careful not to bend the fiber optic cables. Insert the fiber cables for the emitter and receiver in one end of the amplifier and the electric cable in the other end, which then connects to the fiber optic sensor breakout board. Connect the 12-volt power supply cable to the sensor's breakout board, then the DAC port of the breakout board to the RPM port of the DAC. Next, we will install one of the thermocouples in the exhaust in order to measure exhaust temperature. We first drilled a hole through the exhaust, and now we will pass a bolt through the hole and secure it with a lock nut. We then attach the alligator clip thermocouple to the bolt inside the exhaust. Then connect the audio cable and K-type connector to the thermocouple breakout board. Next, we will set up the pressure sensor. Begin by connecting the tubing to the ports on the sensor and attaching the audio jack cable to the side facing the DAC. The other end of the tubing should be connected to a pitot tube, which is not included in the kit. We will now finish our connections at the DAC, starting with the USB-B cable, which will connect to your computer, followed by the sync cable that connects to your sync hub, the 9-volt power supply cable, and the analog inputs for the pressure sensor and the thermocouple sensor. You can then connect the DAC sync cable to the opposite port on the sync hub, going in to out or out to in, and then plug in the power supply to the sync hub, the USB-B cable, and the M8 cable to the FMU. Then connect the other end of the M8 cable to one side of the FMU, and the 3POS GST wire from the fuel flow converter to the other side of the FMU. Finally, install your propeller on your engine, following the instructions provided by the manufacturer. Thanks for watching this installation guide for the FlightStand 60 engine test stand. If you have any questions, you can consult the PDF installation manual linked in the description or leave us a comment below.